Hi, very nice to meet you. My name is Blossom. Welcome to my home, the USC Interaction Lab.
So social assistive robots have been created for a variety of user populations. For example, they have been studied extensively in helping children with autism learn social skills, as well as cognitive skills. Social assistive robots have also been used to help stroke patients adhere to their exercise routines because these can be very laborious and demoralizing. They have also more recently been studied for supporting people who are suffering from anxiety, depression, OCD, and so on.
Here, my robot friends and I want to try our best to help people in the world. Can I ask what's your name?
So social assistive robots have been around for 25 years, but in the last few years, of course, we've had the explosion of AI. And so now when we have a social assistive robot helping a child learn better, the conversation that it has is much more natural, generative, it can be personalized. So really AI has had a major impact on the social side of the interaction.